We do our best to make sure that giving healthy, fresh food to the people who want it, but also being good stewards of the land. So here at Vittone Farms, we are a true ag startup. We actually grow produce hydroponically in a vertical technique system, as you can see behind me here. Container farming means taking or repurposing an existing shipping container. In this case, we use a recycled, refrigerated trailer that has been insulated already. It has been actually manufactured to the specifications that you see here. We chose container farming specifically to be able to control the elements. We're looking at anywhere from a 95 to 98% yield on the equivalent in 1 month behind me here of 2.5 acres of row cropping. Here in Virginia, we can do that 365 days a year. And through sustainability practices, we only use 5 gallons of water a day, and we only lose that on evaporation. Container farming, hydroponic, vertical farming is one of the best ways to conserve water. And we do our best to make sure that we're not only giving healthy, fresh food to the people who want it, but also being good stewards of the land.
I'm Jordan Goodley. I'm the hydroponic crop manager here at Vittone Farms. Obviously, the core of my role is the container farm, planning production as well as carrying everything out. So we start everything inside of a little grow cube. After about 7 to 10 days, it germinates and it goes into our seedling tray. After about 2 to 3 weeks, we're able to move it into our mangrove area, which is all vertical, and it stays there until it is able to be harvested. And so we use an NFT system, so the crops are constantly receiving a nutrient solution that has all the micro and macronutrients that they need on an interval that I've programmed. And then everything is controlled with the temperature range, the humidity, the light schedule. The reason why hydroponics, why indoors, is because indoors we're able to have a completely controlled environment. We never have to worry about the temperature dipping below whatever parameters that we set. You know, we don't have to worry about the humidity being too high or too low. We're able to control all that. We don't have to worry about rain or pests or weeds or anything. And we're also able to use about 95% less water than a conventional farm because it is all controlled and it all returns back to our system because it's all recycled. And because we're in this controlled environment, we don't have to use any unnecessary chemicals or anything like that. You know, we're able to do this in the most natural way possible, which is a seed and going to a complete product just off of light, water, and nutrients. We use these panels here, and that basically the grow cubes are nestled in between two pieces of foam, and in between those two pieces of foam is a wicking strip. So when the irrigation comes on and runs through our PVC pipes, we have 5 little drip emitters for each panel, and then the plant's roots just drink from that wicking strip, and then any excess water runs down to the bottom of the panel and runs through our gutter system back into our tank to be recycled for the next irrigation cycle. Our artificial light, we use spectrum light. We use red light and blue light because these are the two spectrums that plants use for growth. The maximum capacity of our mangrove area is about 6,500 plants. You know, obviously, if we're growing lettuce, we have less of an overall output. If we were just doing basil or cilantro or arugula or kale, you're looking at, you know, 6,500 to 7,000 plants. After harvest, we obviously sanitize our containers. It depends on where it's going. If it's customer direct, we pack it in a clamshell like you would see in a grocery store.
So anybody out there that would really like to learn more about this or maybe start a production like this with vertical hydroponic farming, do a little bit of research. You don't need 100 acres to do this. All you need is a lot big enough for a 40-foot shipping container. One bit of advice that I would have for anyone that wants to get started in any kind of agricultural enterprise is to really, really do your homework. But it starts with a business plan, market research, and understanding that not only your dream is important, but also the execution of that dream is important. I believe the vision of continued success of ag is really based in responding to not only what customers' needs are and customers' wants, but also the new and developing disruptors that are out there, like vertical hydroponic farming. Now we're actually taking a look at what the future has to hold. We're looking at technology. We're looking at better sustainability. We're looking at what else other people are doing. How can we bring it here to Virginia and make it work for Virginia? We're very agile with what we can produce. We have a close relationship with the chefs that we actually serve, as well as the community that buys from us for what they're looking for. Given 6 weeks' notice, we can start doing something as specialized as Swiss chard, which we've done in the past. We had requests for collard greens. We were able to respond to that with a 6-week notice. I see the future of Vittone Farms moving out to more customer direct areas. We've already had a number of customers, restaurants, and other places have asked us to do this on their site. Again, reducing those miles that things have to be delivered and bringing it to the people who want it where exactly they want it.
Vittone Farms came to us because they were coming to the lake, and I thought it was a great partnership. You know, it's hard to, when you deal with big companies and freshness, so that's what Vittone Farms is providing for us. And also because I can get it all year round. Exclusively, we're getting all his lettuces and herbs from Vittone Farms right now.
My relationship with the Farm Credit of Virginia is solid and has been amazing. Starting a business during a pandemic has its own challenges, let alone being able to find a lender that understands that there's new ways of doing agriculture now. As you see here with vertical hydroponic farming in this container farm, there's not a whole lot of people that, one, knew it existed, or two, would actually back a loan on it. Farm Credits of Virginia really, really took the time to understand that this was a sustainable model, and this was something that actually could be worth underwriting. My experience as a startup working with my loan officer with a technology of growing that very few people understood was absolutely hands down amazing. She listened, she did her research, she is very, very communicative with me, and we actually went forward with the business plan and had to make adjustments, don't get me wrong, and she was amazing at recognizing that we're in a pandemic, there are adjustments, and we have to move forward. My experience, hands down, has been amazing.